appetite, they need to do something by May. We took the opportunity of raising it with the Secretary of State when we met the Minister for our meeting in December, so the profile has been raised. So it's a work in progress, but it seems a very retrograde step to me that the intention of the new investment regulations was to move local authority funds into a more similar regulatory regime that private sector funds are in, and this militates against that hugely in terms of setting different criteria for local government funds as opposed to private sector funds, effectively restricting our investment universe. I think probably the biggest lever we've managed to pull is just to say to government, you want us to invest in infrastructure. Infrastructure is only sold to professional investors, so you better give that some thought. The response I wrote is fairly lengthy. It isn't actually, I suppose it only amounts to 2.5 sides, but it probably sets out in a bit more detail some of the issues that we have with the consultation. But it's more just to make you aware that there is an issue there and it's something that we're working on.
No, I don't think Peter's fine saying if we were a private sector defined benefit pension scheme, we would not be affected. This problem is one of the 50 largest funds in the country, probably all private sector. It seems completely incomprehensible that you could be defined as a non, a retail scheme. And then when you look at treasury management paper and you see that the fund is headed by a professional investor, Peter. He has, professional investors in his team. He has his own dedicated, finance team as well, because he learned the local authority to provide a bit of part-time assistance training. It's a full-time dedicated team, which is also involving custodian-type arrangements. It just seems incomprehensible, but as Peter said, we're caught up with some problems we need to link on. As I say, the LGR trying to find a way around it, but it'd be best if we weren't involved in it, but there is no way we can't be. So the best hope is that we'll make the quality and quantity tests sensible.
And again, partly unfamiliarity with local government. Decision making in local government tends to be by committee, whereas the FCA loves having named individuals. So that's one problem, but they say, the individual implementing the decision needs to be able to demonstrate certain knowledge and so on and so on and so forth. Well, the reality is the decision maker is often a committee and the officer implementing the decision isn't the individual who took the decision. I think the FCA are coming around to understand that there are different models of decision making. They're used to dealing with commercial organisations where, in fairness, they have named individuals so that they can be very clear about responsibilities, and named individuals or individuals in functions of significant influence can be held to account. But it's just things that we're working through, but it's hard work.
Any questions or comments?
Agenda item 11, investment management work in 30 minutes.
Yes, Steve.
This is a covering report for the...
That's right, the minutes which are in the closing part of the agenda.
It will reach item 12. And there are three items beyond this which are exempt, so I shall now read the declaration and ask whether members are content to approve this. The following items are considered to contain exempt information, and therefore it is recommended under section 100, practice A, practice 4 of the Local Government Act 1972, the project be excluded from the meeting due consideration of the following items of business on the grounds that they involve likely disclosure of exempt information as defined by the relevant paragraphs of Part 1 of Schedule 12A, brackets as amended, to the Act. The public interest test has been applied and favours exclusion. Do I have a proposal for that motion?
Sure.
Do I have a second? Thank you. Could I now ask any members of the press and public to...
So you've got to vote on it as well?
Yes.
Yeah, they haven't voted yet.
Yes.
It's by show of hands, so. That doesn't apply to the AOB item. Are there any items of AOB or not?
No.